Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create an eerie, bone-chilling x-ray of someone you know. This is an update of a tutorial I did quite a while ago on an earlier version of Photoshop. Before we begin, you can get the most current version of Photoshop and Lightroom and 20 gigabytes of cloud storage all together for only $7.99 per month. Click the link in my video's description to get the discount. I provided an image of a human skull and the upper part of a skeleton so you can follow along. Their links are located in my video's description or project files. Open a well-lit photo of a person looking directly into the camera. It could be color or black and white. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The size of this image is 870 pixels square, and its resolution is 150 pixels per inch. The first step is to convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. A smart object will have this icon at the corner of its thumbnail. If your subject has dark hair or skin, brighten those areas by going to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. I'll make the shadows amount 35%, however, since every photo is different, feel free to adjust this amount. Then click OK. The next step is to make a selection around your subject so we can separate it from its background. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool with a size of 10 pixels. If you're using this tool as well, you may want to use a different size depending on the size and resolution of your document. Drag your tool over your subject to select it. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. Click the Refine Edge button or go to Select and Refine Edge. Check Smart Radius and drag the radius amount a bit to the right. Output it as a new layer and click OK. Control-click or Command-click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer below the active layer. We'll fill the empty layer with a light gray color. To do this, click your foreground color to open the color picker. In the Brightness field, type in 70% and click OK. Since this is now your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Next, we'll add a little grain to the background. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Texture folder and click Grain. Make the grain type Clumped, the intensity anywhere between 10 to 20, and the contrast 50. Then click OK. Make the top layer active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Black White. Click back on the adjustment layer icon and this time click Invert. Open the skull image I provided. To place it onto your subject, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of your subject. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto your subject and release. Reduce its opacity so we can see the face under it. To resize the skull, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Drag it over the face and go to a corner of the transform. When you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out until the skull closely matches the size of the face. Then reposition it so its eye sockets, nose, and teeth are as close as you can to their corresponding positions of your subject's face. Click the Warp icon. You can manipulate the skull's shape by dragging segments of the bounding box or the control points or an area within the mesh. When adjusting a curve, drag the control point handles. Do the best you can to match the positions of the eyes, nose, and mouth, as well as the shape of the skull, including the chin, jawline, and cranium. Then, click the check mark at the top. I'll reduce its opacity to 40%, but feel free to adjust this amount. Open the skeleton image I provided, and as before, drag it onto your subject. Reduce its opacity, and open your transform tool to resize and position it. Click the warp icon. To see the warp transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Manipulate its shape to conform to your subject's neck and shoulders. To accept the transform, click the check mark at the top. I'll make its opacity 30%, but again, you can adjust this amount. To crop off the parts of the skeleton that extend below the visible boundaries of your image, open your rectangular marquee tool and drag a selection over your entire image. Then, go to Image and Crop. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Solid Color. In the hexadecimal field, type in 428E61. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Change its blend mode to Hard Light. To increase its contrast, click back on the adjustment layer icon and click Brightness Contrast. Slide the contrast all the way to the right. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.